Hi everyone, it's Miriam Ortiz y Pino here with More Than Organized, and I just realized I didn't really set my frame up very well. Hello, how are you doing today? I am doing a bit of follow-up on the holiday decor video I did last week. I got some feedback that people were interested in seeing what I actually have done at my house, and I hadn't done it till the weekend. So what I did was I shot a video yesterday that I've posted here on the Facebook page, and you can check it out after this. And I just walk you through what I did inside. And then I created a photo album with some close-ups of what else I did and of the fence, because someone was really interested in how I do that simple garland on my fence. So just to remind you, you can go to morethanorganized.net and sign up for any of the various free things I have there. You can get free simple tips. You can get 5 ways to declutter fast or the 1 minute mail solution kit. Depending on what your biggest struggle with getting organized is, there's something for you there. There's also tons of articles, and several of them are about holidays and ways to make the holidays easier and simplify them and really streamline them so you can have more fun. So check that out. But some highlights of what I wanted to let you know about the other video, which is the decor. And I apologize that I have no idea how to make a live video while I'm walking around and talking and make it look great. I tried one once, and there's a couple tricks that I need, and I don't have the actual equipment to make it work right. So I had to split it up into two. So the description is here. The visuals and specifics are on the other video that will be available on the page called Holiday 2017. But some of the things I wanted to tell you about the process of getting organized, because I talked to you about it last week, and then I actually did it over the next few days. And some things came up, and I realized I should have mentioned that in the video. So I wanted to go over some of what that stuff is. And starting with what was the same. So I always start with a general plan of what I'm going to do. I'm going to have a candlescape. I'm going to put some of my favorite ornaments in these various vessels that I have. There's a vase and a couple of planters or cash pots that I like to use to fill, because they sit on my shelf all the time anyway. And sometimes at the holiday, I just like to fill them with some more sparkle and glitter and ornaments. And that way they pick up the light from the candles, and it makes it more festive. So that stuff stays the same. And I have a few things that are already kind of pre-matched. I have a crystal Christmas tree that is wire and crystal. And then I have one set of really exquisite mercury glass balls that I put on that tree. And then that tree is just silver and clear, and it picks up light all over the place. And I love that. And then I have this very special Santa Claus that I got. Oh gosh, I've had it almost 30 years. And so that one Santa Claus is the only thing in my collection that doesn't have blue, silver, and white. And he does have blue and white on him. He has blue boots, my Santa Claus does. So he always goes in the same place. And then I have this ginormous floor vase that I actually put on my top shelf, and I fill it with blue and silver ornament balls. So that tends to stay the same. Oh, and I hang clear glass ornaments in my window so they catch the light during the day and the candlelight at night. So those are that's the part that stays the same. So a few things went a little bit differently as I started unpacking and looked at what I had and am recovering from the cat catastrophe of last year. My cats pulled over the other little Christmas tree I have and broke about 8 of the ornaments. This was after I had taken that to that same little tree. That's one I travel with when I go to Sedona. And so it as well has, it's a tinsel tree, and it has a matching ornaments set that I got just for that tree. And I lost a few of those when my niece knocked that over at one point. So I'm down to almost no ornaments on that tree. So I didn't set it up yet, because I'm going to take it to Sedona and go to the Christmas store that's there to find some replacements with my niece and nephew. So that didn't get set up yet. And some of the stuff, because it was broken and I wanted to leave it out in case I was finding ornaments during the year that would match, I wanted to have those available for consolidating as I picked up the new things that might go on that tree. I didn't ever get around to it. So it was a little bit separate from that storage box. So that was something that was a little bit the same but different. So it's all together and ready to travel, but I didn't set it up yet. So some of the other things that were different or that you want to evaluate as what's different this year than last year is asking yourself a few questions. Like, what worked last year? What was great? For me, you know, the fence is always good. But I had a couple, the bows were getting really frazzled. And so those went away and I got new bows this year. And so I had to put the rubber bands on the bows so that they would work really easy. So that was something I had to improve on. You want to know what didn't work at all? So figure that out. I didn't have anything in particular that didn't work, except for candles. I love blue candles and I like two or three shades of blue, and I've had the hardest time finding blue candles the last couple of years. So I have, I'm using up the white ones and I have some blue ones on order, but that's one of those things. What do? I need to remind myself to pick up some blue candles throughout the year when they may be more available in the spring and summertime, because those are more spring summer colors, but I like to use them at Christmas. So that's something to note as well. Improvements. There were a few ornaments that I've had for years that were kind of lingering and left over from the time before I set my sights on just blue and clear and silver. And so I decided to wrap those up a little bit separately. So there's a few heirloom ornaments and things. I'm talking like two little boxes this big with a few ornaments in it. And I'm just setting those aside and taking them out of my general ornament population, so they're not in the way as I decorate things. I don't do a whole lot of lights, but I've kept one strand of indoor, just regular off-white lights that I can use for a variety of different celebrations. And I picked up one new strand of on a battery pack, smaller LED lights that work with my garlands nicely. They're just easier to manage. And so it's a strand that's about 4 feet long instead of one that would cover a whole tree, where I didn't have a whole tree. And so I was always having to hide half of the strand behind something. So I made that improvement and upgrade this year as well. I just picked up that one new strand of lights. So there's sometimes too, I used to do a few other areas of the house. I'd maybe put a little bit more garland around the door to my bedroom or something like that. I live in a very modern space, so it's still visible from the living room. I just kept it a lot more simple. I hung up a couple crystal wreaths, sparkly wreaths in the main area just to tie it back. But I kept it more simple. So that's the kind of evaluation. What worked, what didn't, what can be improved, what do you want to let go of, what are you going to never do again? I am probably never going to have a giant tree with the lights and the tinsel and the garland and the ornaments all on the same tree. It's just not conducive to my lifestyle or where I'm at. But having said that, I do have two different trees. They're just scaled way down. So keep those things in mind as well. So enjoy the other video. It will be here on the Facebook page. Called Holiday Decor. I think it's just Holiday 2017. And the album is also Holiday 2017 with some still shots and a look at the outside stuff that didn't make it into the video. And I hope you enjoy. Let me know your comments, your thoughts, things you've picked up, you've decided to do differently this year because you've heard me talk. I'd love to hear how your holiday goes. And next week, we'll get back to regular scheduled programming on productivity and decluttering. And we're going to talk about goal setting and evaluating your year so you can have a better year next year. All right. Thanks again. Don't forget to check out morethanorganized.net. And I'll see you next week. Bye.